Hey everybody, today I'm going to go over how to deploy a new agent and for NovaBackup's Managed Backup solution. I've already logged in to the management portal right here, and what I'm going to do is, first thing I'm going to do is go to the cloud storage accounts here. We need to create a location for the cloud data for this agent to go to. So I'll click Add New Cloud Storage Account. Just keep this default Amazon S3 cloud storage component. I'm just going to call it Acme Cloud Backup. I'm not going to put an encryption key or a quota, but you can certainly do this. And it's recommended that you put encryption keys, but in this case, I'm just going to click Add Cloud Storage Account here. It'll give you a confirmation that it added and everything else. Then I'll go to Agents and Groups. Once I'm in Agents and Groups, you'll see the folder that is associated with your login. In this case, I have a folder called Demo MSP. I'm going to go into it just by hitting View, or you can double-click it and it'll also go there. I'm going to go to Backup Client Setup Installers. So this Backup Client Setup Installers is going to list all of the installers that are available for you. And if it isn't checked next to here, you want to make sure it's checked. If it's the first time you're going to download it, it's going to take a little bit, maybe like 10, 15 minutes, because on the back end, it'll actually build that custom client for you. In this case, I've already done that. So if I click this, it shouldn't take that long, maybe, 30 seconds to a minute. It still has to pull it from the cache, but it should be pretty quick. That was pretty quick. One of the things is it might give you an error or a warning saying, hey, this isn't signed. This is because it is basically custom to you, so it isn't going to be signed in the back end. It's just basically changing the wrapper of that installer so it goes directly to your account. I'll go to Downloads. I'll just go ahead and run this installer so it should pop up. Should show this. Just typical installs. You don't need to do custom installs or anything like that. There's literally no reasons to really do any sort of custom install, except if you don't want like something on there for like the image backup or something like that for some reason, but it doesn't require a reboot or anything like that, so I would just keep it typical. Okay, so you don't even have to launch a software. Just hit finish here. And if I just do a quick refresh on the storage or on my portal, it's going to show up that the machine's already there, which is great. It's already going to show that it is already licensed, so you don't have to do any licensing things. It's actually inheriting that license from the group it's going into. Devices, it's just going to show your C drive. In this case, that's the only thing that's there. But the first thing I want to do is add my cloud storage account. I'll go to Create Devices. I will choose the Amazon S3 compatible, and I'm going to say Existing Cloud Storage Account. When I click Next here, it's going to give me a list of all of the cloud storage accounts I already have out there. In this case, I just have this one, so I'll choose this. I'm going to name it. I'm going to call it like Acme Cloud Backup. You don't need the domain or machine name here. This is only if you need it to basically impersonate another machine that maybe have lost or something like that, like wanted to recover from a different machine. You want it to act as though that other machine is, so you can import it and restore the data. In this case, it's going to read it from that machine, so I just hit Add Device. All right, perfect. And then what I'm also going to do here is click Add Device. I'm going to say local or network storage device. In this case, this is going to be where that local backup data is going to go, whether that's a NAS or a USB drive or something like that. I'm just going to call it, Acme Local Backup. And I'm just going to put it C:backup right now because I don't have anything really set up here. And the encryption key is optional for you. The domain, username, and password are only really needed when you go to like a UNC path or NAS device, that type of thing. Click add there. it's going to push it down to the client. I'm just going to open the client real quick and show you that it down there. Right. So now it has the Acme Cloud Backup, Acme Local Backup. I'll just minimize this. We can actually create the jobs themselves directly from the portal, so you don't even need to go to that client. I'll just create a file backup job. I'm going to call it Acme Cloud Backup Job. And I'm just going to do the users, for instance. And to tell it where to go, in this case, I'm going to do the Acme Cloud Backup device that I set up. By default, it's going to have a retention setting of 30 days. You can change this to whatever you want, you know, weeks, months, years, whatever you want. But by default, when you create a new job, it is going to be set for 30 days. So go ahead and change that to whatever you need to. If you have, it's highly recommended that you put a specific user in for the job. In this case, since this is a demo, I'm not going to do that, but this is really recommended in a live environment because you want it to run as a user that has permissions for whatever you're backing up. So I'll just keep that as a logged in user. And then I'll schedule that. I'll schedule it daily and put it at, like, I don't know, 9 p.m. And when I hit save, it's actually going to send that job down to the client itself. I can check in schedule, and the Acme Cloud Backup job is there, set for 9 o'clock tonight, and it's all ready to roll. You can do the exact same thing with a local backup job. So I'll do that same procedure. Same C colon users. You can drill down into all this stuff too if you want to see everything that's there. So it you can drill down to files and deselect stuff if you need, but in this case I'm just going to do that entire C users folder, and I'm going to choose the local backup destination. Same exact settings for the cloud one, so it's going to default to the 30-day retention. And same with run as and all that stuff. Then I will schedule it same way. And what I usually do is I'll usually run the local one a little bit earlier. It really doesn't matter a whole lot except for the initial backup. The initial backup, obviously for cloud, will typically take a little bit longer than the cloud. But what it will do on the schedule is when you say there's something running when a schedule is supposed to kick off, so say the local backup is taking a long time before the cloud backup kicks off, it'll actually wait for that local backup to finish and then run the cloud one. So if I go down here, now I can see both schedules, and that's pretty much all there is to it. So the agents and groups, it's going to show this, and then once the backups happen in the job history, it's going to show all the logs and that type of thing. Jobs, you can edit and view, edit, delete those jobs that you've already created. And that's about it.